This video provides an explanation of the Sony Virtual Production Toolset functions, its installation method for your PC environment, and how to use the tools. The Virtual Production Toolset is a solution software package that improves the usability of the camera and the LED display in virtual production. The toolset has many functions that increase efficiencies and reduce time for production, as well as improve precision. The Virtual Production Toolset consists of two software products. One is a plugin for Unreal Engine called the Camera and Display plugin. This plugin enables you to reproduce the user interface and the look of the Venice series inside the Unreal Engine, realize high-precision pre-visualization and tech visualization during production, easily set configurations, Moiré Alert, and color managements for on-set shooting. Color Calibrator is a user-friendly Windows application that enables swift color calibration between the camera and the LED display required for on-set shooting. First, this is explanation of how to install the Virtual Production Toolset. Go to the Sony website of your country or region and enter Camera and Display Plugin or Color Calibrator in the search bar on the upper right to display the product page. Click Download on the top of the page, fill the registration form and press the Submit button to complete registration. After an email from Sony Professional Solutions at sony.com notifying a link to a website for downloading the both software is sent to you, click the link shown in the email to access the site and download the software. This is the explanation of installing the camera and display plugin. Double-clicking the installer that you have downloaded automatically starts a setup wizard. Follow the instructions on the screen to install the camera and display plugin. Please install it in the plugin folder where you have installed the Unreal Engine. If you want to have this plugin per your desired project, please install it in the specific plugin folder of that project folder. Next, open the desired project file for Unreal Engine. Ensure that the Unreal Engine's version is supported by the Camera and Display plugin. Select Plugins from the Edit menu, search Camera and Display plugin, and check that it is valid. Restart the Unreal project and if not valid, enter a tick mark to make it valid. This completes the installation of the Camera and Display plugin. The Camera and Display plugin has functions to be used for on-set shooting. However, let's start with how to use the Virtual Venice during pre-visualization. Camera setting items are created to match the Venice series, which makes communication between the camera operator and the Unreal Engine operator easy. Let's place a Virtual Venice actor in the Unreal Engine environment. Input Virtual Venice in the search window of Place Actors on the open Unreal Engine project screen. Drag and drop the actor in the Unreal Engine environment. A Virtual Venice actor with a Venice appearance is positioned in the Unreal Engine world. You can check the output with viewport in the same way as with the Cine camera actor. This is the explanation of what Virtual Venice can do. The Virtual Venice is equipped with functions suitable for the real Venice. You can set up the virtual camera on Unreal Engine as if operating a real Venice. First, select the target camera from camera type. You may select from Venice, Venice 26K, and Venice 28K. Next, select camera filmback from imager mode. Project frame rate. Input color space. Base ISO. Shutter. ND. EI. White balance. From look, you can select a user 3D LUT file in addition to S709, Rec 709, 800%. You can test the LUT file to be used for on-set shooting. And set up ASC CDL to match the project, which enables to reproduce the brightness and tones of camera output for on-set shooting. In addition, lens settings enables to reproduce lens distortion and vignetting. Let's try selecting an angular lens. Distortion and vignetting are enabled. They will be reflected to the viewport, and distortion and vignetting suitable for lens zoom and focus values can be checked from the pre-visualization stage. The above settings enable to output video reflecting the color science and lens characteristics of the Venice. let's take a look at the Moiré Alert. Moiré may generate on the shot contents, depending on the distance and angle of the LED in camera and lens setup. Simulating these from the pre-visualization stage can avoid retakes and plan changes during shooting. This plugin enables to predict Moiré that may occur when using a Sony camera from the pre-visualization stage, as well as predict Moiré that are difficult to visually find in an on-set shooting environment. Here is an explanation of how to display the Moiré Alert during pre-visualization. First, correctly set information of the camera type, position, direction, and lens status required for Moiré Alert to the Virtual VENICE actor. Register End Display on Moiré Alert. Click the Add Display button on Moiré Alert. The Moiré Alert Setup dialog will be displayed. In the Moiré Alert Setup dialog, select the target End Display actor. Place a tick on Show End Displays Only to display only the End Display actor. Select and place a tick on the targeted mesh for the LED display. Select only meshes comprising one display. If there are multiple LED displays for the end display actor, such as for ceiling and sides, repeat the above steps for each display. Select the LED display in use from Display Panel Type preset. Sony's Crystal LED B-Series and Verona are preset for selection. When selecting Other, set up the pitch size from LED pitch size. Select a calculation interval of Moiré appearance with sample distance, and click the Add button. Clicking the OK button in the appeared confirmation message screen registers the display. Turn on the Enable Moiré Alert to enable the Moiré Alert. This makes the Moiré Alert to be displayed according to the current Virtual VENICE position, focus distance, and LED display position. The Moiré Alert status is expressed in colors. The selected mesh will display the colors according to the state of Moiré appearance. Explore camera operation, avoiding alerts in yellow or red to find the camera work, where Moiré will not appear during actual shooting. Here is an introduction of how to output prepared pre-visualization sequences as video footage. Using the Unreal Engine's Movie Render Queue function, preview clips of level sequences, created with the sequencer function, can be written out as still image files such as JPEG, PNG, bitmap, and other formats. To write out image files, perform OCIO settings for Virtual VENICE actors in the Unreal Editor's Movie Render Queue window. First, check if the plugin for the Movie Render Queue is on. Press the clapperboard icon on the Sequencer tab to display the Movie Render Queue window. Press the settings area of the target sequence. Click plus setting in the newly displayed window, select color output, place a tick on, is enabled, on OCIO configuration, then search and select Sony VP OCIO in configuration source. Next, select source for bypass from transform source. Select destination for bypass from transform destination. Perform other rendering settings as needed. After settings are completed, click the Accept button to apply the settings and perform rendering. Virtual VENICE settings can be saved as a file. To save your camera settings during pre-visualization, click the Export Config File button and save the file in your desired location. It can be reused in the subsequent pre-visualization projects, as well as be loaded onto the real VENICE at the shooting site, which reduces on-site setting time. When you save camera setting status, please click Export Config File and select Destination. After completing accurate pre-visualization, let's take a look at the on-set shooting functions of the Virtual Production Toolset. This is the system diagram of the shooting environment using the Virtual Production Toolset. Search and additionally connect the Sony on-set camera component to the Cine camera actor prepared for in-camera VFX. The on-set camera component is a component to shoot in an actual virtual production environment. It can perform color calibration of the camera equipment and the LED display and predict Moiré appearance under an on-set environment. The Virtual VENICE actor appeared during the pre-visualization process is used only in that process. Note that the onset camera component cannot be added to and used with the Virtual VENICE Actor. Set up the camera and the LED display using this Sony onset camera component and change the size of the inner frustum, then set up the color space of the input signals of the LED display. Here are the steps. Select camera type and imager mode. Next, set up open color IO for end display from input color space in onset camera's LED settings by pressing the end display OCIO setting button and click override. Next is performing the color calibration. It is important to perform color calibration for in-camera VFX, however, calibrating manually using a spectroradiometer takes time. The camera and display plugin and the color calibrator app works together to complete the calibration in a short time. The next explanation is how to install the color calibrator. Click the downloaded file, and after completing installation with the installer, ensure that the color calibrator app starts properly. Next, display a chart for color calibration on the LED display from the Unreal Engine and shoot with a real VENICE. First, turn off all the lights in the room. Next, set up your LED processor so that the LED panels can display as PQ and BT2020. After setting the LED processor, please display W100 chart on your LED panels. Make sure W100 chart is displayed at 100 nits emission. Next, set the VENICE for calibration. Please make sure your VENICE settings are correctly set as follows. White balance, 6500K. Exposure index, 800EI for VENICE 28K or 500EI for VENICE or VENICE 26K. Base ISO, ISO 800 for VENICE 28K or ISO 500 for VENICE or VENICE 26K. Recording format, XOCN. Please choose S-gamut3.cine-s-log3 or S-gamut3-s-log3 for input color space. Next, check the camera viewfinder settings. Please turn on Zebra in the monitoring menu. Please check if Zebra Select is at 2 and Zebra 2 level is at 61%. Output video of the viewfinder is set to log. Next, clear ND filter. Place the W100 chart within the lens angle of view. When doing so, adjust the shutter and iris to set the exposure to 61% in S-Log3 so that the zebra appears on the W100 chart. Move the focal point to before the LED so the image is defocused. To perform calibration using the file, start recording with the VENICE. In this state, switch the chart that is displayed on the LED display with the onset camera component. Switch in the order of HDR1, HDR2, HDR3, HDR4, record all displayed charts, and end the recording. It is also possible to have the above operation not recorded in a file, but output from the camera via SDI and input to the PC where the color calibrator is installed. Next, start up the color calibrator. User interface for the color calibration is largely separated into three sections. On the left side is the color manager. It positions the reshot chart to the right side of the original chart. In the center is the image viewer, which displays the file shot with the camera or SDI input of PC. It is also possible to display waveforms. At the right side is the monitor screen, which displays the level of difference of color and gamma before and after the calibration. First, click New Project to create a new project. Load a file that was previously recorded with a VENICE. In this state, display the frame showing charts and press the Take button to take in each shot charts. These steps can also be performed with signals input via SDI. To do this, repeat the steps of changing a chart and pressing the Take button for the number of charts. This is the state when all charts are taken in. You can see the color and linearity of the original and reshot charts are not aligned on the monitor screen. Next, press the calibration button and press export, save it under your preferred file name. A LUT file for calibration is created. You can see how accurately the correction can be made by the calibration tab on the monitor screen. Next, reflect the previously created 3D LUT file in the Unreal Engine project. Click Calibration LUT from the onset camera component and load the created 3D LUT file. Copying the editor PC's project folder to the render node PC and using a file sync system, such as Perforce, enables the application of this 3D LUT file to all LED displays. Starting up the camera control panel from the onset camera component enables monitoring real VENICE settings in real time. Enter the IP address and the password for the VENICE connected via Ethernet and login. The web GUI of the VENICE starts up, enabling to see the parameters in real time. It is also possible to operate the menu and the assignable buttons. Moreover, saving VENICE's settings enables returning to its original state later, or reflecting the settings to the virtual VENICE during the subsequent previsualization. If there is a configuration file for the virtual VENICE recorded during previous previsualization, loading that configuration file to the camera equipment can reduce the setting time. Saving different settings for multiple scenes during previsualization enables the instant loadings of appropriate settings for shooting each scene. Lastly, here is an explanation of the Moiré Alert during on-set shooting using the on-set camera component. Fundamental steps are not different from displaying the Moiré Alerts during previsualization using the virtual VENICE actor. Turn, enable Moiré Alert on to validate display. This makes the Moiré Alert to be displayed according to the information on the output of the camera tracker connected to the ICVFX camera and the lens encoder. When a Moiré Alert is displayed, you can check if Moiré is appearing in an actual camera output. By distributing the Moiré Alert image to the camera operator and the focus puller, it can be used as a real-time alert during on-set shooting. This is the end of the tutorial video for the virtual production toolset. You can download the toolset from this QR code. Please utilize it for your productions.